And Don, let's refresh our viewers a little bit as to who went where and did what. I know we've got a graphic, so we can bring some of that up. But talk about who will be taking over some key positions.
Yeah, well, let's look at Jane Philpott, who's moving from health to take over sort of the hands-on getting services improved for Indigenous people. This is splitting this unwieldy, creaky old structure, as the Prime Minister called it, to try and modernize it, and get ready to hand over the service delivery to Indigenous people themselves. So she's got a real tough row to hoe there. She's been given a real... Carolyn Bennett will deal more on building the relationships up. And some people argue they've deteriorated. The Murdering and Missing Aboriginal Women's Inquiry has foot-dragged and fallen apart and seen resignations. So the whole relationship seems a little off-kilter, frankly, Jennifer, on this one. And so he's put two senior ministers on that one. I think probably one of the more significant moves was Carla Qualtrough. She was a junior minister. And he's parachuted her straight into one of the biggest migraines for any politician. That's dealing with the whole procurement issue, with a very troubled payroll system that's not paying the employees properly. So she will handle the public works and procurement file. And that's a real tough portfolio to handle as well. So that was that one. The interesting one, perhaps a person with a parliamentary secretary, but Jeanette Petipa-Taylor, a Moncton MP, who no one really saw coming up the track this quickly, has been pushed into the health portfolio. Now, there's not a tremendous amount of heavy lifting to be done in that portfolio. Jane Philpott's dealt with a lot of the heavy files already on legalization of marijuana and getting a new funding formula in place for the provinces. Those were the real big jobs. But that doesn't mean health isn't going to bring a lot of challenges going forward. It's top of mind with voters, particularly as they're heading into an election. So, you know, it wasn't a massive shuffle, frankly, Jennifer, but it certainly was far more than we anticipated when Judy Foote, a Newfoundland MP, stepped aside for family reasons. And then we thought, well, we're just going to see a replacement. Instead, we've seen six ministers juggled around a little bit, including a major splitting up of a ministry that Justin Trudeau clearly wants to make his signature accomplishment. That's rebuilding the relationship with Indigenous people. So an interesting day, beautiful day at Rideau Hall, but one that's bringing a bit of a new face to Justin Trudeau, keeping the cabinet more or less at gender parity. Actually, yes. One more woman than man, if you don't count the Prime Minister, but count him, and it's 50-50, right down the middle.
Yeah, and as we saw there, Seamus O'Regan moving into the Ministry of Veterans Affairs, Kent Hare moving out and moving into Sports Ministry as well. You're right. In terms of the key takeaway from this shuffle, it was to split the Indigenous Affairs Ministry into two. What does that say, Don, about how wieldy it was for one person to manage and the problems that it's encountered over the last several decades?
Yeah, the problem is there's this thing called the Indian Act, and all First Nations find this patronizing and outdated and in need of being abolished, more or less. And that's easier said than done. I spent all these decades, or century or more, guiding the government relationship with First Nations. Trudeau has clearly set out to eliminate that act entirely and put Indigenous people on a government-to-government basis, an equality basis, and that's not easily done. The bureaucracy in Indigenous affairs moves very slowly. It's a very cumbersome one. Huge money in that department, and many people question whether the value is there for it, given what's going on in First Nations. Can't even get drinking water or equal quality of education or health services. So the bottom line here is he has put that problem on the fast track by putting two of the people he probably trusts more than almost any other in cabinet to say, fix this problem. We've only got 2 years left. We want these boil water advisories gone within this mandate. That's a huge undertaking. So it's a move forward. We'll see if they can deliver. It's going to be a tough one.
Don Martin, host of Power Play. Good to have you on for your analysis as always. Thank you.
Thank you, Jennifer.